Ja, hallo meine lieben Zuschauer. Wir melden uns heute exklusiv für TV Altenburg einmal nicht aus dem gewohnten Sendegebiet, sondern aus Südamerika. Pantanal, das ist der Name des größten Feuchtgebietes unseres Planeten. Es liegt im Südwesten Brasiliens, unmittelbar an den Landesgrenzen zu Bolivien und Paraguay. Gerade bei uns zu Hause in Thüringen hat ja die Winterzeit bekanntlich einen ganz besonderen Reiz. Und das wirft natürlich die Frage auf, warum man sich dann hier der glühenden Tropensonne und Unmengen von Moskitos aussetzt. Ich bin unterwegs mit einer Expeditionsgruppe von Biologen und Aquarianern aus Deutschland und Österreich, deren Ziel es ist, hier die natürlichen Biotope verschiedener Fischarten zu untersuchen. Noch herrscht hier Trockenzeit, aber in wenigen Wochen würde ich an genau dieser Stelle bereits im Wasser stehen. Dann hat nämlich der Regen die Flüsse, Bäche und Senken des Pantanals geflutet und große Teile der Landschaft in einen riesigen See aus Süßwasser verwandelt. Wie die folgenden Bilder zeigen, hat aber gerade in der Trockenzeit das Pantanal so einiges zu bieten.
First of all, you have to get here. The roads are dirt tracks. And the bridges are also quite different to those in Germany. Only a few people live in the Pantanal, but there are lots of cattle. Besides the Argentinian Pampa and the Llanos in Venezuela, the Pantanal is one of the largest cattle-rearing areas of South America. When the gauchos roam the country with their herds, they sometimes also have to cross the tracks. Then it is time to wait, as cattle have the absolute right of way in the Pantanal, and the traveller will have to plan in a little extra time in South America. Away from the tracks, the Pantanal is an animal paradise. Over 650 different kinds of birds live here, and there are probably several more still undiscovered. Here you also meet the yaribu, a giant stork which is the heraldic symbol of the Pantanal. In the numerous lakes and ponds, there is plenty of food for the big birds and for the breeding of their young. However, there is also the danger for oneself to become part of the food chain, as yacaré caimans exist in almost unimaginable numbers. It's best to watch them from a boat. This way you can get a lot closer to them, as the distance at which they run away is much shorter than if you approach them from land. Whoever wants to get far into the Pantanal will at some point have to change their means of transport. The dirt tracks can be only managed with off-road vehicles fully suited to extreme conditions. Now we are being accompanied by park rangers in order to find the rare hyacinth macaws of the Pantanal. Standing about a meter tall, they are the largest parrots in the world, and most likely also the most beautiful. Hyacinth macaws live in groups, which consist of several couples and their young. As fascinating as the animal world of the Pantanal is, we must not lose sight of our real goal. Here, there is water everywhere, and we're here because of the fish.
Unter Wasserdreharbeiten in südamerikanischen Flüssen gelten zu Recht als schwierig. In der Regel ist das Wasser einfach nicht klar genug, um brauchbare Aufnahmen zu bekommen. Doch keine Regel ohne ihre sprichwörtliche Ausnahme. Und diese Ausnahme fanden wir genau hier.
We have filmed in many waters of South America, but what we are finding here surpasses all our expectations. We want to find the reason for the mystery of the crystal clear water and quickly find an explanation. We are in a so-called well pot. The river floor consists of sand, which is continually on the move everywhere around us. Water from underground wells is pushed by gravity, following the principle of an artesian well, directly into the well basin. Further down, it has to pass through deeper, porous strata and is thereby filtered. Freed from all suspended particles, it is forced out of the ground under great pressure. It is a fascinating natural spectacle, and at the same time, the explanation for the clarity of the water. Fed exclusively by the underground wells, this well pond is created with a diameter of about 100 meters. Alongside other types of fish, we also meet tambaquis. They mainly feed on palm fruits, which have fallen into the water, and they are plentiful. The good supply of food and the clean, oxygen-rich water are the main factors in the abundant fish stocks. Where the well basin empties, the current is really very strong. This is where the water has to pass one last narrows, behind which lies the Big Blue River.